And with all of this going on in Texas and just the United States in general, many Americans are pondering whether or not the country is on the brink of, you could kind of say, a national divorce, as it seems we can't even agree on the most basic things anymore. Joining me now to weigh in on that possibility is someone who has written about it extensively, president of the Texas Nationalist Movement and author of the book, Texit, When and How Texas Will Leave the Union, Daniel Miller. Daniel, great to have you on the show, sir.
Hey, David, thanks for having me on.
Daniel, look, we look at how the Biden administration and, let's be honest, the Democratic Party in general has treated American citizens, particularly conservatives, versus how they're treating illegals coming through largely Texas. They seem to give off the impression they almost seem to prefer illegal immigrants at this point. I mean, is there any hope in coming together again on anything as a nation, if that's the case?
Yeah, I would say that the answer is no. And look, the signs have all been there. Right? And just take the border crisis. I mean, you literally just unpacked this issue with the border crisis. And what most people don't understand is for us here in Texas, this has been a problem not for weeks or months or years, but for decades. And there has been no political will in Washington, D.C. to fix it. And, you know, oftentimes you could say that the vast majority of people in the federal government that are making decisions about the border and immigration are not from states that are directly affected by it. You know, but here in Texas, it's been a significant problem, and it's just one among many problems that highlight the larger issue here. As states, we are very different, and so different that it's impossible to govern us under one umbrella out of Washington, D.C.
No doubt about it. Let's talk about Texas specifically. So the Biden administration has, for the most part, left the state to its own devices in regard to protecting the border. Here comes Governor Greg Abbott and others. That's normally a job for the federal government, obviously, from a U.S. Constitution point. So what about this idea of staying part of a union, America, that doesn't even do anything for a state, especially when it comes to, we know about Article 4, Section 4, and the word invasion that's going on right now in Texas?
Sure. Look, let me just break it down from the perspective and give everyone sort of an idea of why this is so big of a problem. On one of our live streams recently, we had State Representative James White from here in Texas, and he called it like no other elected official has here. He said that it was a deliberate attempt by the federal government to destabilize Texas. Now, you know, that is a very hard pill for a lot of people to swallow, but this is no doubt intentional. You know, we basically had Biden and Harris and really the entire Democratic Party crisscrossing the United States during the last presidential cycle, talking about specifically how they were going to hurt Texas, whether it was the Green New Deal to break the back of the energy and agriculture sector, or this issue with the border and immigration. It is clear that Texas and many other states are in the crosshairs. And so for Texas, what we've got to do, what we've got to understand is our Constitution, Article 1, Section 1 of the Texas Constitution, starts off with the words, Texas is a free and independent state. And it ends with the words in Article 1, Section 1, that the perpetuity of the union depends on the right of local self-government unimpaired to all the states. So at the moment that the federal government decided to step on our toes and prevent us from taking action to secure the lives and property of our citizens here in Texas by securing the border, that moment the federal government declared that the union was at an end.
So therefore, what's the next line of that sentence? Therefore, what exactly? You mentioned in you talk about your book, Texit. Are you calling for a secession? Because let's be honest, that has a lot of implications, and a lot of people will say, yeah, good luck with that.
Well, they could say good luck with that. But the fact of the matter is that over the last 75 years, we've seen over 140 different nation states rise up, right? They didn't fall from space. The earth didn't get any bigger. They were people like us who said that they no longer wanted to be governed by bureaucrats that they don't get to elect. And so obviously the next step that's happening right now here in Texas, I mean, the polling shows that if this goes to a referendum tomorrow, it wins. So the next logical step for us is to ensure that we can get a referendum on this and then replace right now in this election cycle, elected officials that will not carry out the will of the people of Texas on the issue. So we have to put the question to the people of Texas and then let the people of Texas speak, and then we go from there. It is a process. It is not an act. It is a process. But it's one that we intend to follow, this peaceful legislative process. And when the people of Texas look at the situation as it is, the only choice available is for Texas to become a self-governing, independent nation state, secure its own borders, and set its own immigration policy.
You mentioned a process. Help our viewers understand what kind of process, how lengthy this could be, what needs to happen specifically for this to even become a puncher's chance at reality, Daniel.
Yeah, look, we already had the first sort of shot fired over the bow at the beginning of this legislative session. House Bill 1359 would have given the people of Texas a vote on Texas independence. Right now, the organization, the Texas Nationalist Movement, the organization that I'm president of, is running a petition campaign where the collection limit is 80,000 signatures. And with 80,000 signatures, the question, the Texas question, will go on the ballot in a non-binding fashion in the primaries in the spring of 2022. So it is a matter of continuing to push this issue forward, expressing the political will of the people of Texans. That will ultimately culminate in a referendum, which obviously Texas will win. But beyond that, we have to go into that process of dealing with constitutional issues here in Texas, statutory issues, negotiated issues, and transitional issues. So these are all things that are highlighted not only in my book, but on our website at texitnow.org.
You know, Daniel, we're not just seeing division in regards to Texas. We've seen this in other states, Colorado, right? You have Northern Colorado wanting to kind of get away from the liberal Denver policies. And you've also got California wanting to potentially, Northern California, secede. So what's your sense of what's happening in this country? Because it does seem like this country is changing. And I know, you know, in part of your title, you know, and your organization, the word nationalist. And boy, the media loves to take that word nationalist and turn it into something downright negative and all bold 24 font. So why don't you clear up the air and explain what you mean by nationalist, because otherwise Don Lemon is going to be speaking like he's some sort of poet and he doesn't even know it.
Oh, yeah. Look at this face. Does this face look concerned about what Don Lemon says, right?
Right.
Look, nationalism is the textbook that, you know, we take the textbook definition, right? The media, the propagandists like take it to a different place, but we take the textbook definition, which is a love for one's country. And it's an outcropping of people within a landmass that want political independence, right? So that's the textbook definition of nationalism. So any others just tack on, but I want to get to something that you just mentioned, which is the sense in other states. And I want to put it to your viewers like this. Anyone who's not in Texas, who's not really thinking about this, ask yourself this question. If the state that you lived in right now was already a self-governing, independent nation among nations. It had control over its own immigration and border policy. It had its own military, its own currency. It was already an independent nation where its laws began and ended right inside the border. And instead of having a debate on whether or not to leave the union, the question was being asked, do you want to join the union? Knowing what you know about the federal government and the union right now, would you vote to join?
Great question. It's a great question. And it's a question people should ask for sure. And I got to tell you, I mean, I have an answer, but let me just say this, that when we ratified the 16th Amendment, when it came to U.S. taxes being paid to the federal government, and then the federal government had this control over the states that the founders never intended. And I think that was a big part of the problem, but we can get into that another day for sure. But I really appreciate it. Daniel, thanks for being here. Texit is the book. Appreciate it.
Thank you, David.
Yeah, good stuff. And I'm glad he was able to, not clarify, but let's be honest, in this day and age with the media out there saying this and that, you know, it's important to clarify. And why? Because it's important to hear the truth. Is immigration the issue that put this over the top to a degree? Sure, in Texas, but it's not the one that put it over the edge in Colorado. It's not the one necessarily that put it over the edge in California, because there's a lot of stuff going on in California. So look, It's one issue, it's a big issue, but this country has got a lot of work to do for sure. All right, we're back in a moment with Tommy Lahren.